the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth, and my soul shall make boast in the Lord. Shall we boast in the Lord this morning? For he is good, he is faithful. There is none like him. Lord, we lift you up. You are awesome, Lord. You are bigger, Lord, our troubles. You are high and lifted up. His name. Give him praise.
Our God is an awesome
12.
God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God.
Two.
Come on, you sing.
Three, and
our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God.
Everyone,
our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God.
Come on, with one voice.
Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven.
Thank you. Hallelujah. We praise you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Lord, your very presence is here. And Lord, our eyes are on you today. Come minister to every need. We look to you alone. You are our hope.
Wow, Nate, right on the dot at 851.
Everything that we need, oh Lord, is found in you. Touch us, oh Lord, today. Come. Touch every single person. We commit this time into your loving hands. All this we pray in Jesus' name. And everyone say, amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Please be seated in this place. I was just reading this portion of scripture today. It says in Psalms 50, verse 15, call unto me in the day of trouble, and I will deliver you. The Lord wants you to know today, no matter what you're going through in your life, if there's any trouble, if there's any challenge you are facing right now, call unto him. He lives to save you. He is here to help you. Do not despair, my friend. Do not lose yourself in the midst of all your troubles and afflictions and think that he has left you. He has sworn in his word that he will never leave you nor forsake you. Today, place your hope in him. Today, we can look to the cross to understand that God loves us. It's not how good your circumstances are. It's not whether you have your prayers answered the way you want them to be answered. Sometimes it doesn't happen the way you want it to happen, but you still get delivered. You still get your victory. You still get out of the trouble you're in. God has his ways. You need to put your trust in him. Today you can be certain that he loves you because of the cross. He laid down his life for you. He gave everything that he could give for you. Today, place your hope in him. I don't know your trouble. We all have some lesser, some greater, but I know who can save you out of all your troubles. It is Him.
Just testing.
His name is Jesus. It means Savior. It means salvation, and He's here to save you to the uttermost. Place your trust in Him. Okay. Amen. Today, let's look to the cross. Let's remember what our Lord Jesus Christ has done. We can remember Him. Not our troubles. We can remember Him, our Savior. Amen. Hold a brand in your hand, and as you do so, I want you to look to Jesus. Do you see him at the cross? Close your eyes.
Sorry.
See him. Feel his love. Experience his grace. He became a curse that you may be blessed. He became sin that you may become the righteousness of God. My friend, your sins are forgiven. You are blessed. You are healed in every way. Thank him in your own words. Come on. Right now, I declare over you that by the stripes of Jesus Christ, you are healed. Made well. Make whole, you may partake. The precious blood of Jesus Christ that continually washes you of every sin. You are forgiven. You are the Son of the Most High God. You may drink. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, my friend. Sins, all forgiven. May the righteousness of God bless with every spiritual blessing. Amen. This is the life worth living. Run out the ashes of past plastic bags to collect the empty Holy Communion cups. Kindly place your cups into the bags that are being passed, and in a few moments' time, we're going to wait on you for the Lord's offering. If you're writing a check, kindly make it out to New Creation Church. The full cycle of grace. Why do we give? Is it because we have to? If we don't, does it come with a curse attached? Or a series of bad things will happen to our lives because we don't give to God? Is that the reason why we give? To avoid bad things happening to our lives? My friend, that is never the reason. How can anything bad come from a God who is good, who gave His Son to die on the cross for you? He's a good God. Amen. Today we give because He's good, not because He's bad, and we don't want Him to do bad things to us. We give because He's good, because He loves me, because He gave everything to me when He gave His Son to die for me at the cross. This is why we give, because we want to honor Him. We want to worship Him. Amen. So if you are ready, ushers, please pass the offering bags. Let's worship the Lord with our giving.
Genuine coming. is good news.
So good.
Praise the Lord. Come on.
Yeah, clear.
Another round of applause for our wonderful, wonderful singer. Praise God. Hallelujah. Mucha gracias, brother. Praise the Lord.